The serfs who belonged to the manors never got rich. They were at the bottom of feudal society because they owned no land. Serfs were not even allowed to move away from a manor without the lord's permission, because his wealth depended on the labor they supplied. The lord rewarded his serfs for the service of their labor by giving them a place to live, a share of the crops they raised, and protection during dangerous times. Because serfs owned no land, they had nothing to pass down from one generation to the next, so their families always remained poor. In their manor villages, they were not even allowed to grind their own grain into flour for bread. Instead, they had to pay to have it ground at the lord's mill. In feudal society, even though serfs produced nearly all the food, did most of the hard labor, and were the largest class of people, they had few rights and almost no opportunity for education. As a result, it was nearly impossible for them to rise above the poverty that ruled their lives.
Man! Ma'am, sorry. What knight lives in that castle over there?
I'm 37.
What?
I'm 37. I'm not old.
Well, I can't just call you man.
Well, you could say Dennis.
I didn't know you were called Dennis.
Well, you didn't bother to find out, did you?
I did say sorry about the old woman, but from behind you looked...
What I object to is you automatically treat me like an inferior.
Well, I am king.
Oh, king, eh? Very nice. And how do you get that, eh? By exploiting the workers. By hanging on to outdated imperialist dogma which perpetuates the economic and social differences in our society. If there's ever going to be any progress...
Dennis, there's some lovely filth down here! Oh! How'd you do?
How'd you do, good lady? I'm Arthur, King of the Britons. Whose castle is that?
King of the who?
The Britons.
Who are the Britons?
Well, we all are. We are all Britons. And I am your king.
I didn't know we had a king. I thought we were an autonomous collective.
You're fooling yourself. We're living in a dictatorship, a self-perpetuating autocracy in which the working classes...
Oh, there you go, bringing class into it again.
That's what it's all about. If only people would
realize... Please, please, good people, I am in haste. Who lives in that castle?
No one lives there.
Then who is your lord?
We don't have a lord.
What?
I told you, we're an anarcho-syndicalist commune. We take it in turns to act as a sort of executive officer for the week.
Yes.
But all the decisions of that officer have to be ratified at a special bi-weekly meeting.
Yes, I see.
By a civil majority in the case of purely internal affairs.
Be quiet.
But by a two-thirds majority in the case of more...
Be quiet. I order you to be quiet.
Order? Who does he think he is?
I am your king.
Well, I didn't vote for you.
You don't vote for kings.
Well, how'd you become king, then?
The Lady of the Lake. Her arm clad in the purest shimmering samite, held aloft Excalibur from the bosom of the water, signifying by divine providence that I, Arthur, was to carry Excalibur. That is why I'm your king.
Listen, strange women lying in ponds distributing swords is no basis for a system of government. Supreme executive power derives from a mandate from the masses, not from some farcical aquatic ceremony.
Be quiet!
Oh, but you can't expect to wield supreme executive power just because some watery tart threw a sword at you.
Shut up!
Oh, but if I went round saying I was an emperor, just because some moistened bint had lobbed a scimitar at me, they'd put me away.
Shut up! Will you shut up?
Ah, now we see the violence inherent in the system.
Shut up!
Oh, come and see the violence inherent in the system! Help! Help! I'm being repressed!
Bloody peasant!
Oh, what a giveaway. Did you hear that? Did you hear that, eh? That's what I'm on about. Did you see him repressing me? You saw it, didn't you?